I've got a word that I want to give you. Not going to be preaching this morning. Going to be teaching. And so I just need you to help me. Can you help me this morning? Can you help me? All right. So here's the deal. What's coming to you this morning is going to help your thinking and your mind. And 99.9% of your battle is mental. And if you can know the truth will set you free. It'll make you free. And so I'm believing for truth to come this morning. Someone say amen. So let's pray together. Father, I thank you for just the service. And I thank you for the anointing that we felt in this place. I ask you for clarity on my mind. And I ask you for every word that comes out of my mouth to be full of life. I ask you right now to open the heart of your people. Give them understanding. Speak to them. Take this word. Minister to the heart of your people. Father, I declare these things and I ask them through the authority of Jesus' name. And every believer say amen. You may be seated here in the presence of the Lord. I'm going to Romans chapter 8 and verse 30. Romans chapter 8 and verse 30. This morning, I want to talk to you about the three aspects of sin. The three aspects of sin and how Jesus dealt with them. And it's critical that you know this, and especially to have any kind of victory in your life. This morning we're going to talk about the penalty of sin. Somebody say penalty. Penalty of sin, the power of sin, and the presence of sin. We're going to talk about the three P's this morning. Romans chapter 8 and verse 30 says this: moreover, whom he did predestinate, them he also called, and whom he called, them he also justified. So watch this. Predestined, he called us before he laid one, before he hung one star in the sky. He knew you. He knew the day you was going to be saved. God saw this day before it ever came. Not only did he predestine you, he called you. And watch. And then the Bible said that those that he called, he justified. Can you say that word me? Justified? Justified. Say it again. Justified? Justified. Very important. And them he also glorified. I want to key in on the word justified. Because that happened to you when you came to Jesus. Anybody come to Jesus? I'm going to try to help you. I'm going to try to get you to help me this morning. When you came to Jesus, you became justified. That word justified means to be made innocent. It means to be free, and it means to be righteous. Right. Now, I'm not going to try to minimize you this morning, but I'm just telling you what I just said. Most people don't have a revelation of. They really don't know that they are free this morning from the penalty of sin because of Jesus Christ. Because you got to pump too many people and you got to prime them and try to get them excited about the Lord. But can I tell you, when you get this revelation that because of Jesus, your penalty has been paid and you're free from the penalty of sin, right, it'll put a joy and a peace and... Right. Watch this. And here's the question, because the Bible said that God justified us when we came to Jesus. How did God declare us innocent of our sins? How did God do that? How did God declare you to be free from the penalty of your sin? How did God declare you to be free from the penalty of your sin? And I want you to hear this. God did not ignore your sin. God does not ignore sin. How many of you know that to be true this morning? God does not ignore sin. And yet we are all sinners according to the Bible. And when we came to Jesus, the Bible said God declared us to be innocent and free from the penalty of our sin. And I don't have time to get into all of this morning, but we know that the penalty of sin is death. We know that those who don't get right with God are going to hell according to the Bible. And yet God so loved us that he sent his only begotten Son, that whoever believeth in him would not perish but have everlasting life. We're saved this morning because of what Jesus did. Aren't you glad you don't have to work for this or perform it or earn it? Or come on, can I get a witness? So here's the question. Here's the statement. God did not ignore our sin. He says in Romans 3:26, to declare at this time his righteousness, that he might be just and the justifier of him which believeth in Jesus. This is really important. The Bible said that God is just, and at the same time, he is the justifier. He is just and the justifier. To be just, it means that he gives the deserved punishment for sin. He doesn't ignore sin. He doesn't water it down. And for him to be just, sin must be punished. And yet, at the same time, the Bible said that God is just, he is also the justifier. What does that mean? He causes the guilty to be declared innocent. He causes those that deserve the judgment not to receive the judgment. Can I get a witness? Now, watch this morning. The Bible said in Isaiah 53, and I want you to hear this. It says that it pleased God to bruise Jesus. Isaiah 53 and 10. It pleased God to bruise Jesus. Wow. And he had put him to grief when thou shalt make his soul an offering for sin. Now, can you wrap your mind around that this morning? That it pleased God to bruise Jesus? That word bruise, here's what it means. It means to beat into pieces. And the Bible said that it pleased God to beat Jesus into pieces. And you say, why would God do that? He did that for us. He did that for you. Don't you sit in here this morning and question the fact, does God really love me? And is he really for me? All you got to do is remember the old rugged cross. That word bruise, it means to break. It means to destroy. It pleased God to break Jesus, to destroy his flesh. Listen to what the Bible said. Isaiah 53 and 5. Jesus was wounded for your transgression. See, God did not ignore my sin. He judged my sin. But he didn't judge my sin upon me. He judged it upon Jesus. He didn't ignore your sin. He judged your sin. But he loved you. He didn't judge you. He judged the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, I'm going to tell you, Jesus wasn't dragged to the cross. He wasn't forced to go. He willfully went to the cross. He willfully tasted death for every man. He willfully endured the judgment of God. Why? Because he wants us to be saved. He wants us to be accepted with the Father. He wants you to go to heaven. Greater love hath no man than this. If you know what I'm talking about, give God a real shout of praise right here. The penalty of our sin. Jesus paid the penalty of your sin. Now, I want to show a video here. It's graphic. I don't want to be offensive. But a lot of times when we talk about Jesus going to the cross, the Bible just said he was simply crucified. We really don't have a picture of the price that Jesus paid when God judged him for our sin. We really don't have a real clear picture of that. And so if you don't want to watch this, just close your eyes for a minute. It's just about a minute long. But I wanted to play this that you could get a real picture of the judgment that fell on Jesus, not because of his sins, but because of our sins, and because he endured that penalty, that judgment, our penalty has been paid in full. Glory. Okay. About God not ignoring our sins and turn my lights on. God not ignoring our sins, and He didn't ignore your sin. He judged our sin upon the person of Jesus Christ. And that happened over 2,000 years ago, and I want you to know it happened. And that's not the end of the story. They put Him in a grave, and 3 days later, He came up out of that grave with victory. And the thing that you have to understand, and I want you to get this, I want to scream it to you, is that the area of your life that deserves judgment, it fell on Jesus. The area of your life right now that deserves the judgment of God, because there's none of us perfect. There's none of us perfect, and all of us have areas that deserve the judgment of God. But can I tell you, on this Sunday morning, judgment did fall, but it didn't fall on you. It fell on the Lord Jesus Christ. Right. Ryan, can I use you for a moment? Brian James, run down here real quick, brother. Just stand right here, brother. Stand right here. right there in the middle. Face me if you don't mind. So, what is it this morning? Is he a liar? Does he struggle with lying? Does he struggle with fear? Does he struggle with selfishness? Look up here. He struggles with something because he's human. You struggle with something. And here's the question. It's by faith. Can you believe that the penalty of your sin was paid right there by Jesus Christ? That right now, I am free from the penalty of sin. I am free from the penalty of sin. Why? He paid my penalty. He paid my sin debt. Can you receive Christ as your Savior this morning? You say, Brother Paul, I've done that. I got baptized, man. I got the Holy Ghost. I know that. But can you really trust Him as your Savior this morning? That you owe nothing? Your slate is clean? The areas of your life that deserve judgment, it fell on Jesus over 2,000 years ago?
Right.
Come here, Donnie. Let me use you. What's your issue this morning? Let me see. What is your issue this morning? You can't forgive your past. You can't forgive your parents. You struggle with bitterness. He struggles with something. And I'm just going to be honest with you. I don't want to go to a church where everyone acts like they're perfect and there's no issues. I don't want to be a part of a church like that, because every one of us, and I don't want to get ahead of myself, but every one of us, including pastor, is under construction. I don't see no halos this morning. And we need to get rid of our pride in our, and I say that loosely here, because I just, let me preach, I'm not accusing you, but I don't want to be a Pharisee and pretend that we got it all together, when in reality, I still need His grace, I still need His mercy. So, what is it in your life that deserves judgment? Can you, by faith this morning, be free from the penalty of my sin? Because Jesus paid my penalty when He went to the cross. I want you to stand all over this building. I got these two guys here. Who else should... Who else do? Yeah, come here. I heard you. Come on, Annette. Come on, quick. Because I'm not through preaching. I got a lot of word. So what is it that in your life that deserves the judgment of God? It deserves the penalty of the sin. And here's the question: is can you by faith trust that He paid the penalty of your sin? Because that's why He went to the cross. That's why He went to the cross, is to pay the penalty of your sin. That's what this is about, is you coming to Jesus, you trusting that He paid your sin debt. And some of us walk in and we're still under guilt and condemnation because we ain't got this together. Can I stop for a moment? Are you not farther than when you started? I'm not perfect, but my Lord, my life has been changed by the grace and the power of God. Yeah. I'm going to give you about 10 seconds, but I want you to lift your hands to the Lord, and I want you to, by faith, I want you to be free from the penalty of your sin. If you come to Jesus Christ and you put your faith in Him, amen, you are free from the penalty of your sin. He paid your sin debt. 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 Hallelujah. All you got to do is ask Him. All you got to do is ask Him. He already paid the price. All you got to do is accept it and receive it. He's not going to come and die again. He's already died. He already tasted the punishment, the judgment of God. He's already done it. He's not going to come and do it again. Oh God, your debt has already been paid. All you got to do is receive it by faith. You better give God some praise on this Sunday morning. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Thank you. You can be seated. He paid the penalty of your sin. Your sin penalty has been paid in full. Now, what does he do with imperfect people? What does he do with people like us? Areas of our life that deserve judgment? He just paid that. He paid the penalty of my sin. Now watch. Let me give you this scripture. He is now delivering us from the power of sin. There's two aspects. The penalty of sin and the power of sin. The penalty's been paid in full. Can't give me a ticket. Can't judge me. Can't send me to hell. My sin's been paid in full. Hello? I'm going to heaven. Now he is delivering us from the power of sin. And that's what he begins to work on your life. Throw that scripture up for me, sister. It's Hebrews chapter 10 and verse 14. And you can't really move any farther. And I need you to hear this. You're never going to have any victory till you believe that. And I'm sorry, put the picture back up there one more time. I apologize. Put the picture back up there one more time. Then if you don't accept that, then what you're saying is that's not good enough and I'm going to try to earn my salvation. I'm going to do good. I'm going to live a moral life. I'm going to treat people right. I'm going to do everything I can to earn heaven. What you just did is you looked at the cross and said, I don't believe that will save me, so I'm going to work and try to be better. You're doing one or two things. You're either trusting Jesus or you're trusting your performance. And I can tell you right now, on your best day, you'll never be worthy to go to heaven. No man's going to heaven except they come to Jesus Christ, put their faith in his shed blood. Put the scripture up there. I got to hurry. Are you ready? Penalty of our sin has been paid. Now he's delivering us from the power of sin. Hebrews 10:14. For by that one offering, he hath perfected those who are being made holy. When you come to Jesus, you're declared perfect. You're perfect. God sees you through the blood of Jesus. Oh God, I feel like I'm trying to force you to believe this, and I can't do it. Only the Holy Ghost can put faith in your heart and revelation in your heart. But I'm just going to give you one scripture and I'm moving on. The Bible said he made him to be sin who knew no sin, that we might become the righteousness of God. This morning, I've got every right to be here. I've got every right to praise him, not because I'm perfect, but I'm covered by his blood. So now he is making me holy. Now he's delivering you from the power of sin. And that's where a lot of people struggle, is because they don't think they can have issues and be saved. I've had issues from the day I got saved. Well, come on, let me see somebody walk on water right now. We all got issues. Some of you got a temper. Some of you get road rage. Let me hear you, Roger. Uh-oh, called him out in church. I shouldn't do that. Some of you jealous. Some of you don't forgive your past. We've all got things. But we're saved. And he's working on us. Yeah. to deliver us from the power of sin. All right, I got hurt. I was a drug addict, smoked 2 packs of cigarettes a day. I was mean to my wife. I had an attitude. I was selfish. I can go through the list. But when he saved me, you know what he did? He put me on the potter's wheel. And he began to deliver me from nicotine and drugs. It's been over 30 years since I've smoked any cigarettes. Been 30 years since I've done any drugs. It don't it got nothing to do with me. It's his mercy. That's my testimony. That's my testimony. You got testimonies too of what he's done. He's changed us from glory to glory. And I need to tell somebody this morning, if you got an issue, you're in the right place. This is where you get fixed. This is where you get healed. This is where you get delivered. Church isn't for perfect people. Are you ready? Somebody say, I'm ready. When he delivered you from the penalty of sin, it happened instant. Instant. The moment you came to Jesus, I cannot be judged. I've already been judged. I can't be judged. I've already been judged. I've been judged upon the Lord Jesus. Watch. It happened instant. But the deliverance from the power of sin, it's a lifetime. It's a journey. It doesn't happen instant. Now, some things did. Some things I was instantly delivered from. The easy stuff. The easy stuff. But that attitude in me, it's taking a journey of him squeezing and pushing and loving. And how many of you can testify that there were some things that fell off when you got saved? But it's been a lifetime of him working on you and loving you and helping you. And that is too weak, because there's somebody in here feels like they ought to give up because they ain't got it all together. It's our responsibility to let them know it's okay. He's not finished with you yet. Ephesians 2:10. Put it on the screen for me, sister. Ephesians 2:10. Watch this. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 10. Somebody hollered here. I think she went to McDonald's to get... Oh, here it is. I'm sorry. Are you ready? What's the Bible say? What's the scripture say? For we are... Huh? I thought when you got saved, you got perfect. When you got saved from the penalty of sin. Now he's delivering us from the power of sin. Paul said we are his workmanship. I'm under construction. He's not through with you yet. Give him another year. Give him 3 more years. Give him 10 more years. If that don't put your dancing shoes on, ain't nothing going to make you dance. If that don't get you happy, ain't nothing going to get you happy. He's not finished with you yet. Alan. Alan in the house. Where is he at? Hey, stand up real quick. You repair cars, don't you, for a living? What is the fastest repair job you've ever done? 5 minutes, 10, a day? About five-minute repair job. What's the longest repair job? 6 days. So everybody doesn't take the same amount of time. It may have took God 6 months with me. It may have took God 1 week with you. It may have took 10 years to work this out. everything. And can I tell you, look up here, God never looks at a person and says, there's nothing I can do with them. I don't care how messed up you are. I don't care how dysfunctional you are. We got the master. Aren't you thankful that he can save to the uttermost? Aren't you thankful he's able to deliver? There's not a person in here, there's not a person that's going to listen to this message that cannot be saved. He is well able. Philippians 1:6, sister. Philippians 1:6. I'm trying to hurry. Philippians 1:6. The penalty of sin happened instant. But the power of sin, it's a process, man. It's a process. So, don't throw Brother Shelton away yet. God ain't through with him. Don't you say, I don't even know why he comes. I ain't preaching at you. He knows. God's not through with any of us. You got it? Philippians. Watch this. And then I'm moving on. Are you ready? What's the scripture say? Being confident of this very thing, that he which had begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. If it happened instantly, then why does he still need to work on us? Because the deliverance from the power of sin is a process. Let me ask you something. Has God started a good work in any of you? Sure he has. You're here this morning. You're here this morning. There was a time they couldn't drag you to church. Come on. He started a good work in you. We'll be confident that he knows how to maneuver you to where you need to be. He knows how to set you free. Amen. The penalty of sin and the power of sin. The penalty of sin happened instantly when you came to Jesus. Leanne, wouldn't it be a bad thing that the only way you could come into the presence of God is to be in this as long as Brother Cordell? I mean, wouldn't it be bad? I mean, he went to school with Jesus. You know what I'm saying? I mean, that's why I know so much of the Bible. He was there when it was written, man. I mean, but watch this. You know what God does? He puts Leanne and this great elder in the same spot. He puts the brand new one just like the guy that's been in it for 50 years. How does he do that? The blood of the Lamb, Jesus Christ. Can someone say amen? So watch this. Penalty of sin has been paid for it. You're going to have to deal with that. You believe what you want to believe, but you're never going to have no joy until you know, wow, God's for me, not against me. Right. Second thing is, the power of sin is a process. Just keep coming. Just keep coming. Right. Just keep coming. Right. And don't sit on the sideline. Get involved. Right. Give God praise. Get in the prayer room. Reach out. Watch this. But there's a day coming, and I'm through. I'm finished. That he's going to deliver us from the presence of sin. There is a day coming where he's going to deliver us from the presence of sin. What did Paul say? He said, when I do good, evil's there. No matter how much I pray, no matter how much I come to church, I always got something that God needs to work on. But there is coming a day where he's going to remove the presence of sin out of our life. Yes. out of this world, and we're going to be just like He is.
Amen.
I'm going to give you something. You better get ready. This isn't it. This ain't why He saved us. You haven't even walked into your salvation yet. We got the ticket. We're on the plane. But we haven't taken off yet. You won't walk into your redemption until that trumpet sounds. You get your glorified body. No more tears, no more death, no more funerals, no more graveyards, no more goodbyes, no more sickness, no more arthritis, no more... Stand to your feet with me. He says, in that knowing the time, that now it's high time to awake out of sleep, for now is our salvation nearer than when we believed. I thought I was saved. You are saved from the penalty of sin. And He's saving you from the power of sin. But not many more days. And He will deliver you from the presence of sin. It's coming a day. Very shortly. That you won't have them struggles and you won't have them issues. Why? You're going to have a glorified body. You're going to have a perfect mind, a perfect heart, perfect desires. You're going to be just like Jesus. I'm glad I came to teach and not to have a shouting service. Because some of them spots right there, I thought, they're going to shout on that. I just know they're going to shout. I told my brother yesterday, he came in the shop and he said, I'll see you tomorrow. I said, well, come on, man, I got me a message. I can't hardly think about it without crying. Because this changed my life.
Amen. Amen.
No, this changed my life. Because when I first got saved, and it sounds kind of weird, but when I first got saved, I didn't know this. And so I tried to pray a lot and I tried to be perfect. I'd fast. And Leanne, no matter what I did, it was never good enough. If I fasted or I prayed an hour, I should have prayed 2 hours. If I fasted one day, I should have fasted 3 days. No matter what I did. So I constantly lived under condemnation. And I constantly felt like God didn't love me and He wasn't for me because... But that day... where He showed me that I was saved because of what Jesus did, it changed my life forever. I know He loves me. I know He's for me. And I'm telling you this morning, if your faith will be in that, in Him, what He's already done, it'll change your life forever. Maybe you've come to church, but you never come to Jesus. Maybe you quote the scriptures. It was me. I was preaching. But I never came to Jesus. Maybe this morning, Miguel, Keith, Tony, Bonnie, Sherry, Tyler, Chris, maybe this morning we need to come back to the cross and realize He paid my sin debt. And I'm saved because of what Jesus did and all this garbage in my life. He's going to work that out. He's going to help me. I'm His workmanship, and He started a good work in me, and He's promised to finish it. I can tell you right now, God help me. I really believe this, that what brings Him the most joy is when there's a real peace in your heart. because you're trusting what Jesus did on that cross. A bad day can't wash away the blood. A mistake, a struggle can't wash away the blood. Hello? I don't believe an issue can wash away the blood. I'm on the potter's wheel. He's working on my life. You believe what you want. Say one day, backslid the next day. Say one day. But you believe, that's why you ain't got no joy. There's a difference between falling and falling away. I've fallen several times, but thank God I never fell away. This morning, I'm praying. I'm praying for you to walk down to the front. You're not joining the church. You're not. That's not what we're talking about. We're talking about coming back to Jesus and trusting what he did on that old rugged cross, and trusting that he can work out the issues in my life. He's going to help you. I wonder if there's anybody with pastor that says, wow, I needed that word. And I'm coming down and I'm going to walk in that. This altar's open. If you'll come down and just begin to thank God for Jesus Christ and his shed blood, and just know that the penalty of my sin has been paid in full. Let's worship, brother. Let's worship. Go ahead. Let's worship.
I'm forgiven because you were forsaken.
Ooh. Ooh.
And I'm Ooh. Accepted, Lord. You were condemned. Oh, I'm alive and well. Your spirit lives within me because you died and rose again.
Come on, I dare you to worship him.
And I'm forgiven because you were forsaken. And I'm accepted. You were condemned. Oh, I'm alive and well. Your spirit lives within me.
Come on, worship.
Because you died and rose. Again, amazing love, how can it be that you, my King, would die for me? Amazing love, I know it's true, and it's my joy.
Worship him.
In all I do, I honor you. And I'm forgiven because you were forsaken. And I'm accepted, Lord. You were condemned.
Come on, worship, worship, worship.
Oh, I'm alive and well. Your spirit lives within me.
Paid in full.
Because you died and rose again.
Hallelujah.
Amazing love. How can it be that you, my King, would die for me? Amazing love, I know it's true, and it's my joy to honor.
Come on, let's
you.
All sing it with her. Come on, let's all sing it with her.
Amazing love, how can it be that you, my King, would die for me? Amazing love, how
Worship the Lord. Just worship the Lord. Come on, worship the Lord. Yeah, keep playing. Keep strumming there, good brother, if you don't mind. Hallelujah. 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 The Bible said there's not one sin you know he paid the sin of homosexuality. You know that? He paid that penalty. That's why someone who's homosexual, lesbian, gay can be saved. Name a lifestyle. He paid that. And does he have the power to change the heart, the mind, the desire? Absolutely. There are degrees, and I'm through. There are degrees in our heart and our mind. We think, well, this is a little sin. This is a big sin. Can I tell you something this morning? That whatever you think is a big sin, Jesus paid that debt in full. Paid it in full. Will you receive his forgiveness this morning? Will you receive what he did on the cross this morning in your life? I'm asking you one more time to lift your hands to the Lord. I want you to receive by faith what Jesus did on that cross. I want you to receive it now. God, I come against these thoughts that bind and keep us prisoners of faults and mistakes in the past. God, I ask you to tear that down in Jesus' name. Let there be a faith to receive the gospel of Jesus Christ. Let there be a faith in our heart and in our spirit to receive the gospel of Jesus Christ. To receive the gospel of Jesus Christ. Father, grant it in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. 30 seconds of just worshiping and praising him. 30 seconds of praising him. I hear somebody. Don't quench that Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Don't quench that Holy Ghost. Someone say amen. Now we're going to see. We're going to see who received this word. Because if you go out of here looking like you sucked on sour lemons, you didn't get it. You go out of here with your head down. You didn't get it. Come on back to church and do your religious thing. But those who got it, wow, I feel better. Wow. Father, I thank you this morning, number one, for never giving up on me. I thank you for helping me and working on me. I thank you, Father, for everything that you've done in my family. I honor you this morning. And I thank you for the truth. I thank you for the gospel this morning. And Lord, I'm thankful that this word will not return void. People's going to come to this revelation. They're going to see and they're going to be made free. I thank you for the freedom that's coming in this church. I thank you for the liberty that's coming in the lives of your people. Thank you for the great victory you've given us. I just ask you to seal this right now in Jesus' name. Go with us as we go home. Keep us till the appointed time tonight. Father, we honor you in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name we pray, and every believer say amen. Come on, can you give him one more shout of praise?